or 1 Timothy 3:8. Those two men back there when Moses threw down Israel, they, Yannis and Jambres, called Jannis and Jambres. They threw down their rod, so guess what? They didn't know that Moses is rod, which had become a serpent or a snake, would have eaten up their rod. Because they were trying to oppose the Almighty or withstand. That's why we have now this man withstanding the Holy Spirit in Paul. Read that again.
But
Elymas the sorcerer.
What Elymas the sorcerer for? So his name by interpretation.
Yes.
Withstood them, seeking to turn away the deputy from the faith.
Now the faith is Yahshua, manifested through Paul by the who was talking. Read.
Then Saul, who is called Paul.
Paulus means short, is it? But he was Saul.
Filled with the Holy Spirit.
Filled with Yahshua, who is the Holy Spirit.
Set his eyes on him.
Set his eyes on the Son of Jesus.
And said,
originally the son of Jesus, because there was no J back there. Read.
And said, oh, full of all subtlety.
Oh, full of all mischief making, he's a genuine, he's a subtle man.
And all mischief.
Yes.
Thou child of the devil.
Thou what?
Child of the devil.
No, the King James Version is the only book, Bible, that uses the word child. That word child is associated with cuddling, love, and affection.
Son.
It's the same son of, or child of. Look, bar Jesus, son of Jesus, son of the devil, the child of the devil. Bar, son of, Jesus. You see it? Juxta means near positioning. It's a word in English. Juxtaposition. During World War II, Adolf Hitler made sure to have some films about rats. Some dirty giant rats running. People are afraid of rats. Millions of them. And you know what that bridge did? Interspersed the showing of the rats with the showing of the Hebrews, who were nicknamed Jews. So you had the Jews running and crying because they were being chased to be put in the gas chambers to be gassed and killed. So people would watch these films and then suddenly switch to rats. Suddenly back to the Jews, suddenly back to rats. So in juxtaposition, the association between the Jew and the rats made people, he was hoping, but it didn't happen, hate Jews, many fellow Germans. You see, in juxtaposition, you see that Bar Jesus means the son of the devil, Jesus means devil. Why? Because Bar Jonah means the son of Jonah. In John 1:42, the sailor is the same sailor speaking in Matthew 16, verse 13 to 17.
Matthew.
So, John 1:42. And then Matthew 16, 13 to 17.
John 1:42.
Yes.
And he brought him to Yahshua.
Somebody brought Peter to Yahshua, really.
And when Yahshua beheld him,
when Yahshua looked at him,
he said,
Thou art Simon,
son of Jonah.
Good. Now the same Savior, who is Yahshua, was speaking to the same Simon in Matthew chapter 13. Matthew chapter 16, verse 13. Read.
Then Yahshua came into the water of Caesarea Philippi. He asked his disciples, saying,
now all the disciples, there were 12 in. Read.
Who do men say I am? I, the Son of Man, am. And they said, some said that Noah are John the Baptist.
So all of them were talking or answering the question, who do human beings say I am? And the disciples, someone said this one girl. What did they say?
And he said unto them.
What did they say? Some said what?
Some said, are John the Baptist. Some
you are Yohanan the Baptizer. Read
some
on.
Some say it's Elijah. Others
you are Elijah. That's the prophet who we now call Elijah. Read on.
Are Jeremiah or some of them?
Jeremiah. Some people back there thought it was a reincarnation of the prophet Jeremiah. No, it was Yahshua. Read on.
He said unto them.
He said to them.
Say he that I am.
But who do all of you here, the 12 of you here, say?
And Simon
Who do you say I am?
And Simon Peter answered and said.
Simon who? Peter.
Simon Peter.
No, he was one of the oldest, if not the oldest, of the disciples who were quickly becoming apostles. He said what?
Thou art the Messiah, the Son of the living.
Thou art the anointed one, which in Hebrew is Messiah. That's why it is dangerous to be against it. Which in 1 John chapter 1, chapter 4, verse 1, it says, all who do not confess that Yahshua is come in the flesh. Yahshua is come in the flesh. In us, no, we are flesh. And he is come to be resurrected in us while we remain in this flesh. See, but who is in the flesh? It's the soul in the flesh. So really, Yahshua is not in the flesh. You're seeing so. The cornflakes is in a little bag, which is in the box. Cornflakes is not in the box. It's in a little plastic, grease-coated bag. That now is in the box. I'm talking about Fosco. So Yahshua is in the soul, which is in the flesh for a time. Thou art Simon, read.
Matthew 16, 17, Yahshua answered and said unto him, blessed art thou, Simon, Bar-Jonah, for flesh and blood hath not revealed it unto thee, but my Father which is in heaven.
Blessed him. Blessed art thou, Simon, Bar-Jonah, son of Jonah, he had said in John 1:42, now he said Bar-Jonah. Remember, Bar-Jesus, the Holy Spirit said, thou art the son of the devil. Jesus means devil. Did everybody say? You don't like it? Get a million pair of scissors and start cutting. That will have a million years. But there are billions of Bibles. All of them have that. And those wretched ministers won't tell people that the name Jesus means devil. Which the Holy Spirit confessed in Acts chapter 16, verse 17.
Acts 16, verse 17. The same followed Paul. By Jesus.
Yeah, we did it already.
No, Acts 13.
Verse 10, I should have said. This was
what? Then Saul, who is called Paul, filled with the Holy Spirit, set his eyes on him and said, O full of all subtlety and all mischief, thou child of the devil.
Yes.
Thou art enemy of all righteousness.
Now the enemy of all righteousness is who all churches praise and worship and have their hymnals and anthems ascribing praise to. What can we get out of them? It took a vision and revelation to clarify them. You see, after we go through the name, they were just ready now to start eating up the vision. But this is important.
Very.
Exceptionally important. This is crucially important. Now look. Yahshua is coming in his Father's name. For what purpose? Matthew 1:21, she shall bring forth a son. Thou shalt call his name Yahshua, for he shall save his people from their sins. The word sure, sometimes the Bible translates as salvation. Exodus chapter 15, verse 1 and 2. Isaiah chapter 12, verse 2. And then Matthew 1:21 again.
Exodus 15, 1 and
2. Verse 2.
Verse 2. Yahweh is my strength.
Yes. Yahweh is my strength.
And song.
And my song.
And he is become my salvation.
Is become?
Yeah.
That's a good hopeful thing. He really is, but he wasn't showing it back there.
Right.
The other one says, is to become or is become? The Holy Name says what? What are you reading? King James? Holy Name. You have to follow it up. 15 verse 2 of Exodus.
Is to become.
Yeah, and that one says, is
he
become.
He is.
Is
become, become my salvation.
I prefer is become.
Yeah.
But it was already manifest. All right, Isaiah 12 verse 2.
Isaiah 12 verse 2. Behold, my salvation.
Now Elohim is a word hated by the house of Yahweh. Don't be fooled. There are many organizations like the one who made that Bible. The Holy Name Bible. We didn't print it. It's not our Bible. We don't have any Bible. Because Satan didn't say search Bible, he said search the scriptures. These Bibles, all of them have mistakes. I heard some this evening in the Bible reading. Matthew 28, full of mistakes. You see, now look. These Bibles have these errors. Read on.
For Elohim is my salvation, I will trust and not be afraid.
Yes. So Yahweh Elohim is my salvation, but some of them, the house of Yahweh, they promote Yahweh and they promote Yahshua and they denounce the title Elohim. But Yahshua used this title on the cross in Matthew 27, verse 46, Elohim, Elohim, Lama, Sabachthani, my Elohim, why hast thou forsaken me? The devil so hates this title that he says that means my God, that's a lie. Matthew 27, verse 46.
And about the ninth hour?
No, the ninth hour is 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Because the first hour is from 6 morning to 7. Second, from 7 to 8. Third hour, from 8 to 9. So the sixth hour would be from 12 to 1. You see? And the ninth hour would be from 3 going onwards in the afternoon. And the 12th hour is sunset in the ancient clock. So about the ninth hour, 3 o'clock in the afternoon, read.
Yahshua cried with a loud voice.
No, he still had a little life in that battered body, which had a crown of thorns, which had nails in the hands, the side was pierced. You see, the feet, it's possibly, it's obvious that he was also castrated with his penis and his testicles taken off completely. You think it's a joke, this thing about Yahshua? You come bring up this piece of filth to the Father's face when he went through so much suffering. Why? Because he had to fulfill the bullock. And the bullock was a castrated bull. Read.
Yahshua cried with a loud voice.
Cried with
saying,
a loud voice.
Say, Eli, Eli.
Elohim, Elohim.
Lama sabachthani.
Why hast thou forsaken me? So this is a pure and righteous title. And that's why we are Elohim. Why are we Elohim? Because we are his offspring. You know, that's Acts 17 verse 28.
Acts 17.
And that's Psalm 83 verse 6. Read.
Acts 17 verse 28. Mm-hmm. For in him we live and move and have our being.
We have our being, read.
As certain also of your own poets have said.
The poet was David back there in Psalm 83 verse 6. Read.
For we are also his offspring.
We are his offspring. We were created. We are a portion of him from eternity. I'm talking about the soul. The physical body was created from the dust of the earth of Adam. But his soul is from eternity, if he is saved, or to be saved, manifested the soul, which is from eternity, saved. Oh, that's the bell. All right, let's read it. 5 minutes left. Read.
That's it.
Hmm?
That's right. Matthew 27.
Yeah, man. What is it?
You're fine, we move and be now, also.
Oh, yeah, well, all right, after that, no, we are his offspring. That's why we are told in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 49, these words. So, though we look physical.
1 Corinthians 15, verse 49.
49, yes.
And as we are born the image of the earthy.
No, for so many years, we have this image of the earthy. Mm-hmm.
We shall also bear the image of the heavenly.
We shall also go back to the bearing the image of the spirit man, which is the soul inside. And that's why the next verse denounces this.
No, this I say, brethren.
Read.
That flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of Yahweh.
That's just the Bible. or the box. It's not the cornflakes or the oats, which is the soul. I'm just comparing. He wants who is inside, even the monkey knows to throw in the useless skin. He eats the banana. You want the milk, not the bottle. If you bite the bottle, it will cut your pure inside and kill it. Yahweh doesn't want the flesh. So when Matthew 27, verse number 9, comes to talk about the hell of it, that's a lie. Read it.
Matthew 27, verse 9.
Read verse 8 and 9.
Wherefore, that field was called the field of blood.
You have to catch a trend. Read verse 7.
Alright, 7. And they took counsel and bought with them the potter's field.
Yeah, because they say, look, tell them that he didn't raise from the dead, didn't rise from the dead. See? They want to block the fact that he's the resurrection and the life. Read on.
Field to bury strangers in.
Mm-hmm.
Wherefore that field was called the field of blood. Unto this day.
Mm-hmm.
Then was fulfilled that was spoken of by Jeremiah, the prophet, saying, and they took the 30 pieces of silver, the price of him that was valued. Oh,
look, that's the wrong place. Where is it where it said that the hell is field? Matthew 27.
Oh, yeah. 28.
Mm-hmm.
It said hell is field.
Yeah. Read verse 27.
Verse 27.
Mm-hmm.
No.
You know, somebody's looking at it and won't tell me where it is. Where in Matthew 27 is it said that he was held? Somebody held his foot. That's impossible. Go and try to worship him. Matthew 27.
No, in Matthew 28.
Matthew 28?
Yeah.
Oh. Yes, all right. Matthew, my apologies. That was reading, Matthew 28.
Yes, sir.
Verse 9.
Verse 9. You know, I said verse 9, but I said the wrong chapter.
Yeah.
Matthew
28, verse 9.
Yes.
And as they went to tell his disciples, mm-hmm. behold, Yahshua met them, saying,
no, this is the spirit man. He does not have flesh anymore.
Saying, all hail.
All hail. Greetings to all of you.
And they came and held him by his feet.
Really?
And worshipped him.
Could never hold him by his spirit feet, because they are flesh. That translation is wrong. They appreciated him in some mental way or other. And that's why even in Luke chapter 24, when he said of him that he said he has flesh, or he said, is there any fish? Luke 24 verse about, I don't know if it's 48 or 9.
41.
Read. Read who has
it. They believe not for joy, mm-hmm. and wondered, he said unto them, have ye here any food?
You have any food and things to eat? Read on.
And
this is the resurrected being talking. Read.
And he gave them a piece of boiled fish.
Yeah, they gave him. Bowl. They gave him.
And they gave him a piece of
Broiled fish.
And honey comb.
Mm-hmm. Spirit
and
talking.
And his meat
before
them.
That's possible. But what did he say?
And he said unto them, these are the words which I spake unto you while I was yet with you, but all things must be fulfilled.
Sure.
In the law of Moses and in the prophets and in the Psalms concerned.
No, there was a time when they were fearful. And he said,
but they were terrified. 37.
Yes. Read.
And then 36.
Read quickly now.
And thus spake Yahshua himself, stood in the midst of them, and said unto them, peace be unto you.
Peace be unto you.
But they were terrified and afraid.
They were frightened.
And supposed
that they're saying, in the Jeremiah, it's something referred to as a dove in your ghost. But it's a Holy Spirit.
And
read.
Suppose that they have seen a spirit.
You see that, man? Of course it was a spirit. But the Holy Spirit. Not WHOLLYGHOST. Entire ghost. Or Holy. It's the Holy Spirit. See there, Holy Spirit? Read. They went.
And
Reach 38. 38.
And he said unto them, why are ye troubled?
Why are all of you troubled? That's what why he means ye.
And why do thoughts arise in your heart?
Yeah.
Behold my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Handle me, see. For I a spirit and not flesh and bones as is in the heart.
The very most important words are the words as ye see ye have. You have it. They just thought they saw it. He didn't have flesh and bone. He was spirit. Just as those wretches back there at Sodom saw the angels and wanted to go have sexual intercourse because they were homosexual. Sodomites. But they looked at Lot and said, step aside, we want them alive. You see, after we finish with them, we will do worse than we just the angels blinded them. They were spirit. But they thought they were looking at physical. Yahshua is spirit. And they that worship him, same of Yahweh and Yahshua, must worship him in spirit and in truth. You see? That's what he said of it. So this vision and revelation is a spirit vision. It's metaphysical, beyond the physical. And the law of the spirit of life in Yahshua the Messiah has made us free from this law of sin and death. This was a physical law requiring some 603 physical requirements written by man. You know, Yahweh dictating it. See, the old ancient covenant. And 10 of them more, Yahweh himself wrote the 10 commandments. So 10 and 603 are 630 physical requirements. Law of sin and death. You read Romans 8 verse 1. It says the law of the spirit of life in Yahshua the Messiah has made us free from it. Go pay the tithes and offering. That's Numbers 18:24. It's for the Levites only. In spite of what the minister says in quoting Malachi chapter 5.
Right.
You see, or 3 verse 5, somewhere there, shall a man rob God. Don't keep any Sabbath for the physical outward flesh. Because Yahshua said in Matthew 11, verse 28, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavily laden. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek, that is gentle, you know, and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest unto your physical bodies. No, not at all. Unto your souls. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. It's not any Sabbath for any physical body anymore. No tithes and offering, no physical body. What? Circumcision? It must now be of the heart. Circumcision is not of the penis anymore or the foreskin. It's of the heart. You see? Circumcised. That's Isaiah. I think it's Jeremiah, chapter 9, verse 25. Holy name version. Well, 10. It says, born to those men who are circumcised, but not circumcised in heart. So anything we look at back there in that law, it is now spirit. That's why he said, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth on me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. Whosoever liveth and believeth on me shall never die. You know what they're doing nowadays? They're trying to denounce the Bible and the scripture. These ministers of religion. Marrying men. That's why they found it on church. But Isaiah was prophesying it in Isaiah 29, verse 13. Isaiah 29, 13. You know, Yahshua was reading that same thing to them. In Matthew, I think it's 15 verse 7 right now. Isaiah 29 verse 12 or 12.
And the book is delivered to him.
No. Isaiah 29 verse 13.
Wherefore, Yahweh said, for as much as this people can hear me with their mouth.
No, these ministers of religion nowadays promoting this. And some in assemblies of Yahweh, also of Yahweh, Beth Hashem Midrash. They are promoting the true name, but they're trying to mix it with ancient covenant. Read.
Yeah. With their mouth and with their lips, do honor me.
Do honor me.
But remove their heart far from me.
That's it. See? What, so why? Because they got teaching in church. Read.
And their fear toward me.
The worshipping of me.
Taught by the precept.
It's taught by the precept or understanding of men. It's not in man to guide the soul. You see, read up. Jeremiah 23 verse 10 says that. So let's look what Yahshua said now in Matthew chapter 15, I think, about verse 7. But then I will
15
come.
Verse 7.
Read.
Ye hypocrites.
Ye hypocrites.
Well did Isaiah prophesy of you.
He was reading that same thing.
These people draw nigh unto me with their mouth, but honor me with their lips, but their hearts are far from me.
You get yourself back in church, you're going before tables of vomit. Isaiah 28 verse 8. It's right there. Are you going before men called ministers of religion whose faces are plastered with feces? S-H-I-T on their faces. Facing the congregation. Why? Because Malachi chapter 2 verse 2 says it. Yahweh will put it on them. What is it made of? It is made of this. It's worse than what comes out of the dog. Lord God, you must have the better. Malachi 2 verse 2.
Malachi 2 verse 2. The verse 1. And now ye priests, this commandment is for you. If ye will not hear, and if ye will not lay to heart, give glory unto my name, saith Yahweh of hosts, I will even send a curse upon you. I will curse your blessings. Yea, I have cursed them already because ye have not laid to heart. Behold, I will corrupt your seed and spread dung upon your faces, even the dung of your stolen thieves.
Solemn no feast and assemblies. One shall take you away with it. To honor his name is to be ridden of that destiny. And that destiny is for all who hate Yahweh Elohim Yahshua. And hate the Messiah as anti-Messiah. It's a blessing to the Antichrist. Because you are against Christ, Krishna as the Almighty. Do not be anti-Messiah. You get it straight as I have to myself. Because these Bibles are full of pitfalls. You see, so the Holy Spirit in us will correct us to see that Yahweh so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. That whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For Yahweh sent not Yahshua into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. He that believeth on him is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already, because he doesn't believe in the name of the only begotten Son of Yahweh. And this is the condemnation. That light is coming to the world, and men of darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil. You see, and they stay away from the light and prefer the darkness. But Yahshua is the light of the world. I am the light of the world. He that believeth on me shall never walk in darkness, but shall have the light of everlasting life. John 12 verse 8, I think, says that. I don't have any time left to you. So we'll come down now. And that is why we read in Romans chapter 1 verse 16, we ought not to be ashamed of the glad tidings of Yahshua the Messiah, the death, burial, and resurrection. The resurrected one, the only one for our soul's salvation through the eternity. For he is the propitiation for our sin. And that sin is forgiven in him. See? No condemnation to us anymore in Romans 8 and onwards. And when that day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. Suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house with their city. And so that was extended even to the Gentiles physically in Acts chapter 10 and 11. Where Peter said it's not for him to obstruct the Holy Spirit to go suggest any physical water, but in verse 17 of Acts 11. You see? So let us be very happy to be in class and to keep coming on time. Never try the trick this evening with the light. We didn't have lights, so we shall be here. But we're still here, and we shall be in light throughout eternity where there is no night. See? All the praises be to Yahweh Elohim Yahshua. Hallelujah.
Thursday, 9 p.m.
What did you have to say?
11 and 12.
11 and 12 of February, right?
Yeah.
At Champion College. That's the Saturday and Sunday. We're entirely. 10 to 6, what?
Yes.
10 to 6. That's 11 to 12 of February at Champion College. We use the reference is the Spanish on S2 and the Panamena L Street and Tuesday turns from 7:30 to 9 p.m. and on Sundays from 4 to 6 p.m. Also, at 94B on November and Wednesdays from 6 to 8 p.m. Fridays from 6 to 8:30 p.m. and Sundays from 11 to 1 p.m. Can we ask that for that?
Hallelujah.